a pastor.
Yeah.
I know you want to try to live the best life that you can, but none of us here on earth are perfect. Mm-hmm. But I understand about 3 years ago, you were arrested for theft. Would you,
get your facts
straight,
Matt.
Would you care to elaborate on that story?
How did I know? How did I know that was going to come up? Mm. Yeah, so definitely not arrested. No record there.
I see.
But definitely chastised in humor.
Uh-huh.
So you want the whole story?
Yeah, tell me so that somebody else that maybe doesn't know that story.
Okay, yeah. So yeah, it'd probably be good to clarify on the record, right?
Uh-huh.
Common practice was to leave work in the morning and stop at the gas station in Ossian. And what I love about small towns is you can get your gas and then go inside and pay, where as in some of the bigger cities, you have to pay at the pump. So I made it a habit to get my fuel, go in, get a cup of coffee, and then pay. What's funny about this story is typically I would always run into Chief Rigney in there, and we would say hi, good morning, whatever. So I got my fuel, I was walking in, and there happened to be a really nice brand new Suburban there that had the automatic running boards. So when you open the door, they come out. And if I'm being completely honest, I was lusting after the truck when I walked in.
Mm-hmm.
And so I get distracted thinking about that. I go in, get my coffee, and as I'm walking up to the front to pay, almost ran into somebody who was coming down a different aisle. And said sorry, and they, you know, said, no, go ahead. So I got up there really quick, and I was kind of flustered, just wanting to get out of the way, and opened up my wallet, saw a couple dollars, had my coffee, threw a couple bucks down, paid for my coffee, walked out the door, jumped in the truck, went to work. And probably about an hour later, I hear some sirens. And so I just happened to yell down the hallway to some of the other guys. It's like, somebody's getting pulled over. And I heard one of the other guys say, yeah, and he's right here at our front door. And I thought, what in the world? So I walked and I looked out one of the windows, and there's one of the Ossian police cars there right at the front door with the lights going and everything. So I thought, I don't know, what is going on? So we walked around the hallway and we're going down, and I hear somebody say, it's Chief. So I was like, oh, he's here. He's just going to pick on somebody. And then, of course, the rest of it's caught on film and floating around on Facebook for the world to see.
Mm-hmm.
Walked in, and he showed me a piece of paper, and one picture had me walking away from the pump, and the other one was me standing at the counter. And I thought, wow, this guy really went to a lot of trouble to give me a hard time, you know? And it took me a little while to figure out that I had forgotten to pay for my fuel. In the midst of all the confusion, I just left. So it was very humorous, and they gave me a hard time, and it's ended up on the stage Sunday mornings multiple times as an example. So took about 2 years to live that down.
Yeah. I heard there's a criminal in here.
Oh yeah? It's right there. It's right there.
Pointing everywhere.
Oh, it's you.
It's you.
What are you doing?
What's he stealing?
What did you get? You pulled that from?
Oh my goodness.
You stole some gas this morning, man.
No.
What's up with that?
Oh, I forgot to pay for my gas.
You knew that. Oh, man.
Take him in, Chief. Book him.
Oh,
book him, Nano. Put the cuffs on him. Haul him away. Come on, throw him in the back seat. We want to see that.
I did. I hit pay inside, and then I paid cash for my coffee.
Oh, yeah, that old excuse. You've heard that one before, haven't you, Chief?
Oh,
you're not going to buy that.
Oh,
come on, Chief.
Oh, my goodness.
Cuff him and stuff him. Come on, right now. Do it. Take him down. Taser him. Taser him. Come on, Chief. Don't let him get away with it.
Just take my life.